Ho! It is Sydney, it is Sydney, it is Sydney, it is he. We are shaking, we are quaking. Can it be, oh, can it be? It is Sid, it is Sid, it is Sid. It's the agent who's been with me a long time. Who's sitting on the couch?
Hank, please, I'm your agent, not your mother.
You are my mother.
All right, I'm your mother.
What are you doing here?
Your wife called and said you wanted to see me.
Right. I told her to do that.
You're something about a Regis Philbin job offer.
Get this. This guy has been offered his own late night show. He wants me to sidekick.
Well, good for Regis. He's a sweet kid. Huh?
He is.
You're not thinking of going with him, are you?
No. But, now just listen to this, okay? Right. Just listen.
Listen.
He leaves the morning show. There's a vacancy. Is that right? Right. So, think about it. Live with Hank and Kathy Lee.
Hankala, Tsatskala, this is not a smart move. Here, the Larry Sanders Show, this is your base. Where did you come up with such a fucked idea?
I don't know. I was thinking about it over lunch.
Lunch with your wife?
Yeah, lunch with my wife. She was there.
The last time I had lunch with my wife, I ended up redoing the living room in a pattern that I'm not allowed to sit down on.
This is my own decision.
Hank, the wife is on line 4.
Hello? Yeah. Who are you? Mm-hmm. Yes? Yeah, he's right here. We're talking about it right now. Yeah. Yeah. I promise you. Can I have a little privacy, please?
You realize I'll have to get up.
Yes. Thank you.
Okay, I got yeah. Oh boy, yeah, wow, wow.
He's leaving now.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I could probably. No, he's doing his leaving thing. Yeah.
Just a mild concussion, don't worry.
Please. Okay, tell me something I want to hear.
What, I don't get the song?
No, not this time. Come on.
All right. I called Kathy Lee at home. I spoke to her.
Yes.
On the phone, and she's a nice girl.
Yes, come on.
I ran the idea by her.
Yes, come on. Come on.
She feels there'll be some difficulty.
She said that?
In so many words.
What'd she say?
She doesn't want to work with you.
She said that?
In so many words.
Come on, what
is... She hates you.
She hates me? How could she hate me? She doesn't even know me.
She mentioned something about an auto show in Buffalo in 1979 where you locked her in the trunk of a Camaro where she puts it for laughs.
No.
What?
Oh, no. That's Kathy Lee Crosby. No. Oh. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Shit.
Listen, it's better.
No,
it's better.
No, you're
going
to kill me.
You can stay here where you belong.
I had a fight with Arthur, and he found out about the job, and I quit. You know? What are we going to do?
I will tell you one thing. You talk to Regis, you tell him you'd be very happy to be his sidekick.
Okay.
Can you live with that? Or more importantly, can your wife live with that?
Well, I'm ready as soon as you want it.
Fabulous, fabulous. We're going to start in the fall of 97.
What'd you say?
Fall of 97.
But when are you leaving the morning show?
When my contract expires, which is in the fall of 97.
But you're not quitting the show now.
No, what are you nuts, Hank? That show's everything to me. It's my base, it's where I live, it's it. I can't.
Fall of 97?
Yeah. Hank, you okay?
Yeah. Does Joyce ever give you a career advice?
No, never. Hey, you all right?
Yeah.
Hank.
Jesus! Right, Hank! tell me about the Tonight Show thing and what you did there. What was that about? I know you can't discuss some of it for legal reasons.
Well, to be honest, I'm facing a year in jail, and I really didn't think we were going to bring it up.
Well, we don't have to if you don't want to. I just thought it was kind
of... No, I jinkly said I didn't want to.
Let's talk about something else then, okay? You want to do that? I was just curious why you did that thing on the Tonight Show.
Well,
why,
it worked. Why you would do it that. Worked.
The lighting the chair worked?
Yeah, I mean, that's why you have me on here tonight.
No, we have you on, and I may say this, we are big fans of
your chair. Oh, it's bullshit. That's why you have
me. No, Bob, all right.
See, that's why you have me on. It's like, you go crazy, go nuts. Dance for us, monkey boy, dance.
Okay, we'll be right back with Michael Bolton right after this break. Michael Bolton. You know, Leno's right. You can't do that kind of thing. I thought you were going to stick to the questions. You could have really hurt somebody. Are you aware of that?
I thought it was funny. I'm sorry.
You thought it
Here's
was funny?
Here's the man you should be apologizing to, this old man in the wheelchair, asshole.
I'm sorry. I didn't know you were there.
One minute I'm standing behind the curtain eating a mint. The next thing I know, I got a cardboard mountain up my ass. You young people don't know what funny is. Eddie Cantor was funny. If I didn't have arthritis, I'd knock you right on your ass. Six.
Happy now?
Sorry.
Okay. I'll escort you to the dressing room in case you get the urge to push a Coke machine over on Michael Bolton.
I wouldn't do it if it wasn't televised.
Oh, come on, you fucking asshole.
No. Larry, Hank has something to say.
Yeah, I just, well, bottom line is I'm just... I'm a fucking mess.
My marriage.
My marriage is a...
My life.
My life is a...
All right, fine,
mess.
It's fine. This is fine.
What do you mean it's fine? I mean, I can stay?
Yeah, you stay.
Really?
Yeah. See you tomorrow?
See you tomorrow.
Great. A little smile?
Okay.
Good.
Tell Artie.
Tell Artie what?
Would you... tell Artie?
You're breaking my heart, lover, you know that?
Oh, shut up, Sid. You don't care about me because you're my agent. I pay you 10% to care about me.
7.5%, you cheap bastard. Mm-hmm. Hank, a lot sold. So your marriage has turned to shit. I know what you're going through, but this with the whores and the boys.
You know what I'm going through, do you?
Yeah.
You've been married to the same lady for 56 years.
I'm thinking of getting out.
Please.
Hank, and don't be such a putz with the hookers. It's bad for your reputation. Hank, what you need is a special woman.
I had a special woman. And now I don't have a special woman.
No.
That is what I'm doing in this fucking hotel.
I don't mean a wife. I mean a hooker. Somebody who's discreet, can be trusted. Somebody who doesn't look like a hooker. That would be very special indeed. Now, could you hand me the phone, Hank, please?
Yeah, I've known Sid for... just close to 40 years now. I kid you not. Sid is a good man. I did him once. In 1956. It's only the one time. Now we're dear, dear friends.
Copies, not a copy. Copies, as in more than one.
In the first place, we do not panic. It's like the Rob Lowe situation. Nobody remembers the Rob Lowe tapes.
Rob Lowe.
Rob Lowe.
Rob Lowe.
Rob Lowe.
Excuse me. Just an easy question. Don't want to shake you up. What's my name?
Irving Sussman.
What's my name?
Hank King.
Kingsley.
I know your name.
Rob Lowe has a Playboy image, right?
So?
Okay, so?
Yeah, all right. Go ahead.
People think of Hank Kingsley as just a meat and potatoes guy.
Right, true,
you know?
True.
A guy you can invite over for dinner. Hey, Hank. What are you doing tonight? You want some dinner? Come on over. We're having some meat and potatoes. What's that? You can't make it? You're busy? What are you doing? Well, I'm just fucking two women! Would you say something?
It's cycles. Show business is cycles.
Do you understand how humiliating this is? Do you understand how exposed I feel? My God, I could lose the orange growers deal.
Who knew you were going to pull out your pecker on camera?
This is what you choose to say to me at this moment.
I didn't do it.
This is how you choose to represent. You know, maybe I need a younger agent.
Oh, Hank,
I'm not kidding. I'm talking to some people at William Morris. One of them is in his 60s. He's looking very good. So don't mess around.
All right, fine. Tell Larry and Art we can handle everything but the loss of this job. In the meantime, I'll snoop around town like a bloodhound to look for the tape. Help me.
All right.
Oh, God.
Easy.
I have to get more exercise.
Come on.
And I gotta find the gym that'll take me.
Come on.